Ruck, don't run. Dom, why do you say that? Well, look, this pretty much comes down to the benefits of rucking over those that I see that most people think are going to happen when they start running. And why do they run? Because from the outside looking in, people tend to see as running as something that's easy. Well, I'm already walking, I'll just increase the pace a bit. Now, why am I running? Well, most times it is typically because someone wants to lose some weight, because that's what they see everyone else doing. Without understanding the consequences of running is actually a skill. But what's the one thing I want to dial into today? And I want to talk about that there, and that's the thing of runner's knee, or the impact that running has on the knees. Never mind the lower back, the core, the stability problems that we're going to face. Let's just focus on the knee. Now, for me, a guy who's around 200 pounds or around 90 odd kilos, that means that every time I go to run, the load on my knee per every strike of my foot is around 8 times. It's around 1600 pounds. That's per foot strike on that single knee. Now, comparatively speaking, when I am just simply going for a walk, it's only around 540 pounds, or about 2.7 times. Simple mathematics, hey? I can continue just going for a walk and, you know, take the dogs out, go around, take 30 minutes nice and easy, maybe not even break a sweat, and I'm not smashing my knees up. Or I can go for a run and put 1,600 pounds of force through each knee each time I hit my clodhoppers to the floor. Now, why do I ruck? Well, because I want the benefits of rucking. I want to get the development of my core. It actually has helped me with my lower back problems. It forces me to stand upright, because that's what rucking does when you start to add the weight to it. And also too, when I start to hit that slight hill or even on the flat, I've got to work a little bit harder because I'm carrying that extra weight in that backpack. Now, here's an example. Rucking with 20 pounds or 10 kilos or thereabouts, that same foot strike goes from 544 from walking only to 598. Again, still nowhere near the running. If I whack in 30 pounds or about 14 to 15 kilos, it's 626. And if I ruck at 25 kilos or 50 pounds, I'm only talking 680. So I'm talking under 1,000 pounds less four strike. Now, for those of you who have done 50 pounds in a ruck, it ain't light and it does tax you and you will breathe hard. Never mind the whole, if you're into the calorie burn, what that will do to you as well too, because you're basically walking under load. So rucking versus running, for me, it's my go-to. I'd rather do that every single day and a bit longer on the weekends than go out for a run. But that doesn't take away from the benefits of running if I just dial into one thing, and that being just freedom. The ability, because I can move, I wanna get outside, I wanna take the dogs, I wanna go for a run. But if you're starting off and you're a beginner, or you're just someone who's maybe been sitting on the sidelines for a little bit too long and it's time to get back out there, particularly here in Australia because the summer weather is upon us, then before you think about running, please start with a walk. Go for a walk. Tomorrow go for a bit walk, a bit further, a bit faster. When you want a bit of a challenge, find a knee, find a trail, find a hill, do whatever. And you want even more of a challenge, then again, I suggest you think about taking up rucking. But let me say this, after a while you'll find it will become a little bit addictive. Me, case in point, my ruck is heavy. And I have developed the core. And I've developed the core a little bit more than what I expected to. So no matter what your sport, no matter what your chosen venture, please understand that your body will adapt. But in the case of off the couch to the 5K, we're not going to go and smash our knees and pay the consequences because we simply didn't let our body prepare. That's it. It's Dom. Now, if you want to know a little bit more about some of the stuff that I do have the websites, the funnel, landing pages, all the bits and pieces. Simply go into the bio and click on one of those links and you hear more about the blueprint that I've put together for people getting off the sidelines, particularly those over 40 who want to start to feel a bit more athletic. They want to increase the strength and want to become a bit more anti-fragile. That's the stuff between the ears, the headspace, the mindset, as people call it. If you want to know more, simply click on one of those links, and I would love the opportunity to have a chat with you. But other than that, guys, think about a ruck over a run.